heroes and heroines of all ages. When the world tells you to get a life, you're always welcome at the One Up Block. My name is Dan, the man, your host, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play. Shantae, half genie hero. When we last left off, we took on a giant worm and beat the piss out of it and got rid of a bad memory. And now, this episode's probably gonna be almost entirely backtracking. So, I apologize ahead of time, but if you want to know where some items are, right now Shantae is looking for the Dark Shard, and we could start off. Yeah, you know what? We're gonna start off. First of all, give this chick the egg. The monster egg that she wanted, because she wants that protein. Nice. The fortress is built one brick at a time, so it is with your body. Never forget. Here, a reward for your efforts. We got another heart holder. Hooray. I have no need of that. Why, thank you. We could take a stop at the bathhouse to recover our magic. Because, you know, why not? And to start the adventure of the next part, we have Rotters! Hello, Roddy Tops. How you doing, babe? Hey, Snack Cakes. What's up? Don't call me that. Okay. So, listen. I've always wanted to go to the big race with my brothers, but those two were dead broke. Big race? The raceway at Cape Crustacean. Bring two tickets to the big race, and in return, I'll give you something nice. Roddy, why do you have to be so difficult? So that's our next thing we need to do, but over here, we have two very familiar ladies. Yo. Hey, girlfriend. Twitch and vinegar. You're ammo baron soldiers. Don't worry. We're not here to cause trouble. We're on R&R. Anytime we're assigned a new station, we make it a point to sample the local flavors before things get ugly. We heard the food here was to die for. I think there's a restaurant over on Main Street, but it's kind of on fire. No, not that foo-fooey, not that foo-fooey stuff. We're here to try the gator steaks. We heard that there's some kind of reptile lurking in the dark caverns of Mermaid Falls. Two gator steaks served well done would be perfect. Make sure they're seared to perfection. Use a high flame to lock in all those juices, yum. Pull this off and we'll give you our extra race ticket. Are those gator steaks for us? So this is why I had you guys gather the gator steaks, because yes, you gave the gator steak. Oh man, this is one succulent slice of gator. Melts in your mouth. What do we owe you? Oh, right. That extra race ticket. Here you are then. You got the race ticket, one of two. See you around. Bye-bye. So that's the first part done and out of the way. So that's pretty good, right? Making some pretty good time on that. But for now, we're just going to be backtracking. And if I need to skip it, I will skip it. But if it doesn't take too long to get where we need to go, I'm just going to show it off. But first, we're going to be taking our trip back to Tasseltown. Because there's a couple of important things that we can get from Tasseltown right now by revisiting it. I think. If we can't and I'm wrong, then I'm sorry. I'm wasting your time. But hey. What would a Let's Play be if I didn't waste your time sometimes, you know? Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. And let's go. So this place has basically not changed. The wind is no longer blowing in that one section of the stage, I don't believe. I guess I could take the time to grind out some money. It'd probably be a good idea, but our first destination is actually relatively into the stage. If you recall, we passed a door that led to a place that we couldn't get to because there was a sandstorm brewing and we couldn't get through it. But, if you haven't guessed yet, we can use the elephant to get past that wind. Actually, we need the crab for this. Wow, I can't believe I actually made that. Wait, give me that money. Money. Boink. Ooh, okay. Hey. Rude dude. Actually, I could just be the elephant and like ram through this. I ain't playing no games with you. Oh, this is a bad idea. Don't be the elephant for that. You don't want to be an elephant in quicksand. That sounds like a bad idea. That is a recipe for disaster. It was a four-course meal of no siree. It seems that happily ever after was happy everyone was after me. It was a cup of good intentions, a tablespoon of one big mess, a dash of overreaction. I assume you know the rest. One little slip. It's like the best thing to come out of that Chicken Little movie. I love that song. But there's something else that we can do there, but we can't do it yet. You can probably guess what we need to do that, but I'm not going to spoil it. Not quite yet. Just in case it's a surprise for somebody, please don't. Do not touch me. I am precious belly dancer. I basically just wasted your guys' time walking all the way over here. I could have just did this off screen, but, you know, I figured you guys like my company. Plus, I got to sing a song. So, into here we go. I'm not sure if I can make this jump. Yeah, I can. So, just use the elephant. The elephant can't be pushed by the winds. And here we have a secret transformation. Ba-ba-boom! The spider dance. All right, future Dan, put spider dance, make spider dance play during this entire scene. Double jump to grapple the ceiling, press triangle to dance. So with the spider dance, which hopefully is playing in the background right now, we can turn into Spider Shantae, who is absolutely adorable. And when you double jump, you'll actually shoot webbing out of her thorax, abdomen, I don't know what it's called. And you can actually cling to the roof of a building. So isn't that the bee's knees? That is one of the things we came to this level for. Not everything. We do still need to do something. No. All these enemies I gotta get through, and that dude's gonna drop a bomb on me. He didn't drop the bomb on me. You dropped the bomb. Also, if you hit these body parts, they drop money. Not sure if I mentioned that, but here you go. Also, these flowers seem to be everywhere. What can we do with those? Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. So now that we're back here, just like I said before, that worm is now dead and we won't have to deal with it. Whoa, you a grave robber? Not me. Genealogy guy. Build your family tree and what? I'm here looking for remains. Remains are all around us. You can tell where they're buried because flowers grow there. Person goes in the dirt. Person turns into plant food. Gotta unearth them remains. It's a dirty job, but comes with the territory. Bring me 5 remains. They're in this tower. Just gotta figure out where. Also take this. And we got the elephant stomp. Ba-ba-boom! That is how we do some stuff here. But before... Aw, man, really? I guess I can't backtrack. There's a couple of things that I do need to backtrack for, but we'll do that later. After I finish this level, I'll cut back to the area to show you what we can get from using the elephant stomp. But using the elephant, we can break a couple of these. And doing so, we can find some of the plants. You got remains, 1 of 5. So we're going to have to come back to this place anyway later. But for now, I'm going to just get this out of the way. Because aside from... getting plot relevant stuff, I can actually also collect some money, and you know, we have to do this anyway, so I'm doing it now, so forget you. Screw you, I'm doing it anyway. All we're doing really is finding secret areas and then stomping to get the remains out of them. It's nothing terribly difficult. Don't worry. Don't worry your pretty little heads. I guess though, if you're watching this isn't too terribly interesting to look at, but so is the fate of a walkthrough. One who does a walkthrough is destined to hopefully entertain with his voice in stupidity, for if he does not, the audience is damned to watch his boring doing general shit in a video game. Also, I don't think these guys blow fire anymore, so that's pretty helpful. That's pretty nice of them. So again, you're just looking for any of these statues that your elephant can reach. They're all relatively simple to point out. We can't do this yet. Forget you saw that. Ow. Will you... Ugh. How inconvenient. Boom! Ho-ho, we could do this one. Boink. 3 of 5. So once we get to 4 of 5, I want to be careful because there is something I want to do before we actually get the last one. Because once you get the last one, it puts you back at the bottom of the area. Which is convenient, yes, but there's also something I want to do. Also, ow. Boom. Boink. Thank you for healing me. This is probably just a gym collecting area. Which I'm not about to complain about. I will never complain about that. Aw, damn it. You suck. Hello. What might you be? Gems. Gems are exciting. Ooh, gem. Hig. Okay. Using the elephant, we can smash this. Skadoosh. Transform. Sometimes when Shantae transforms, she says it very lazily. I don't know if that's a joke or something, but it's pretty adorable. There's another gallery key. Nothing we need. Nothing relevant to anything, but you can see that some snakes are going to pop out right there because you can kind of see their butt spawning in. It's kind of weird, actually, but... climbing up here, we will find this, which we can smack with our face. You know, typical. Okay, really? That guy's gonna come out of nowhere. Dude, get off my case. Actually, I didn't need to be the elephant. What am I doing? I can do this with normal Shantae. Oh, poop. We can actually turn to the elephant and go here, which this might be the last one. No, it's not. This is the fourth one, right? Yep. Okay, so we have one more. I just have to be really careful about that last one I get because I don't want to get forced to the bottom. I gotta climb up here now. I don't think I can do this yet either. I'm pretty sure this is a secret puzzle that you're supposed to be like, oh, aha, look what I figured out. Yes, that's exactly what that is. So we're just gonna ignore that for now. Yep, rip, 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 rip. I'm a monkey Richard. I'm a monkey Richard. I'm a monkey Richard. I think that might be the remains. Let me check real quick. Let me just stomp and not get it. Yep, that's the remains. We're not going to get those yet. Hopefully, they'll just wait for me right there. They will. Cool. So now I just ignore them entirely. I want that. I want all the gems I can possibly get. Also, there's a door up here that we can't reach, obviously. I think this is another place I can't go to. Yes, this is another puzzle that I can't do quite yet. But we're pretty close to the top. Once you're at the top, I kind of want that jar over there. But once you're here, you can actually transform into the spider and fandangle your way a little bit. You kind of have to work the controls a little bit. But if you get up here, I think we can get up here anyway, right? There's a... Oh, ho, ho, look at that. Boink. Boom, we got ourselves a heart holder. Vada voom, bada bing, bada boom, baby. But now we can go back and complete the mission that we were told to do, which is just right here. It's not too far. Whoop. Oh, damn it, really? Sneak attack, you bastard. We got the remains. Oh, I gotta talk to him. You deliver those remains for me? You gave the remains. Nice. Achoo! You got sick.
Sorry about that. Got you sick. Might want to get that checked out by a doctor.
Why, thank you, kind sir. But I will have to backtrack now, and this will require me to complete the level and jump back in, so I will be back. Well, you'll be happy to know that was an entire waste of time. I didn't need to do that at all. So our next step is going to be going to Mermaid Falls. Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. Once here, we can do a couple of things. Number one, using the elephant stomp we just earned, we can actually pick up a piece of scrap metal here. These are part of a side quest that we can do later, so I'll pick them up on the way because all they require is the elephant stomp and I can now effectively collect those. But there is some stuff that's in the water that I can collect too that I'm not going to because it requires a little bit of extra stuff, so I'm not going to bother with it quite yet. I know about the stuff we can get. Don't worry, guys. I'm intentionally avoiding it. But here we can actually get another new transformation, which is pretty sweet, and it's relatively early on in the level. I was about to say episode, but I guess it is kind of an episode. They're all like little mini episodes. Also, these Nagas, or is that what they're called? Nagas? They drop monster eggs. They also shoot lasers from their hips, which is pretty insane. But I'm pretty sure I showed this off before. But when we have the elephant, we can knock this over. And ba-boom, we get another transformation. You can probably already tell what it is, but we get the mermaid dance. Use this power to travel freely underwater, or freely. So this one's kind of confusing. A lot of people are like, why even have the crab if you're going to have the mermaid? But I don't know, they both kind of serve their purposes. I'm fine with both of them. The crab's pretty cute. But now we have two new transformations. Hallelujah. And I think there's something we can do. Well, there is something we can do here, but not quite. Well, hold on. Check it out. We're going to skip ahead. Going to go back to town real quick. Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. Town. Let's see if we can do this. Let's see if I have access to this quest yet. Because, as you recall, we got sick from that dude. Like, that was our reward for helping him. We physically got sick. And he's not here, so never mind. We can't do that quest yet. I lied. Oh, poop. I was gonna go buy the warp dance. Let me go do that real quick. Because I'm now at a point in time where money isn't really an issue, and I can kind of just grind money in my off time anyway, so I'm not gonna bother not buying the warp dance. Because, you know, why not? I can show some stuff off. The warp dance is the thing that lets you warp to different parts of the map, but you'll see it in a second once I get it. Warp dance. It costs 200, so it costs a shit ton, but hey. Gonna also buy some upgrades to my hair. And let's get the pike ball upgrade, shall we? Because the scimitar is hella sweet. I can't use it yet, but it is hella sweet. I'm probably going to be making sure I buy that before we progress too much farther. But where am I going? Right, I can't do the side quest, so we're going to continue on with our adventures. Adventures in backtracking with Dan the Man, your host. Gonna go collect some shit, you know what I'm saying? Whoop. Into the falls we go. Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. Okey-doke. So there is nothing else I want to do in this area right now as we're talking. Actually, you know what? No, we can't. Can we? No, we can't. Okay, so I was kind of pondering. I had to think for a second. But we can do the warp dance, which is on the third go-through. Whoop! And it will put us in the very next area. So look at that. So before we do anything, we have these new guys. I'm not sure if I showed these guys off. I think they were they in the first time through? I can't remember. I'm sorry. I got bad memory, guys. But for our first time through, we're just going to want to run all the way to the right. I think this is nothing but gems, but I'll check it out anyway. It's exactly what it was. Okay. You can ride these, pretty much. Just get to the end of this area, because if you remember, there was a type of secret area that was to the right of here. There's another piece of scrap metal. Ba-boop. Come on, come on, come on. Hip. Oh, damn it. Yep. There we go. Yep. Do not touch me, for I am a monkey, Richard. I'm a monkey. And through this wall, we get whatever the hell that thing is. Using the monkey bullet, we can come talk to it. Oh, hi there, young lady. I'm Grandma Blobfish. I'd offer you to sit for a spell, but I'm in a bit of a kerfuffle right now. My grandkids have run off, you see. Keeping tabs on the little rascals is like breaking snakes over dry cereal. They're right around here somewhere. Could you spare some time for an old woman? Oh, sure, why not? That's wonderful. Here, I've got something for you. Bum 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 bum, you got the crab claw. It'll help you slice through all the grassy stuff. There are 5 blobfish kids in all. Please tell them it's time to come home to Gram Gram. There's nothing at the bottom of this water, so don't bother turning into the crab. But now that we have Crab Shantae, we can actually... Well, now that we have the pincer attack, which is an attack for the crab, number one, we can get through this grassy stuff, which I have not shown off yet. And boom! We now have another side quest. Collect all the little doodads. Collect all the little blobfish dudes. And if you can see down there, there's another collectible. That's the collectibles I've sort of been avoiding because we require one more thing before we can actually effectively collect all of them. So I'm not going to bother with them. Not just yet. But this side quest to get all of the blobfish is actually doable. If you look down here, you get a better look at the item. It's like a skull. They're called sunken skulls. Not going to touch it though. So I can show off exactly where each and every one of them is. But here is one of the reasons why we can't collect all of those. It's a rock. I wonder what we can do to break a rock underwater. Sounds kind of familiar. But no spoilies. Sorry, I think that might have clipped a little bit. When I speak really loudly, I have to make sure not to aim my face towards the mic. Pretty bad at it. Yeah. Meh. Blobfish. Is there another one over here? Yep. Poink. Poink. You could have actually come back and collected a couple of these beforehand if you wanted to, honestly. You just couldn't get some of them because you require the use of the pincer. There's one down there. I gotta turn back, though, because I gotta be up here. Whoop. Poink. Ow. Ouch! That hurt. How dare you? How dare you hurt poor Shantae? I think we only have one more left, right? I wasn't counting. I lost count. Let's go check. Yep. Bip. Rip. This should be the last one, right? Ba-boop. Yeah, boy. Yep. Yep. Rip. Now we just need to get back to the other end again. So starts our long journey of running to the right once more. Gosh dang. Gimme on there. Okay. Good. Thank you. Was it that hard? Was it really that hard? Oh, shit. Duh. I'm a monkey, Richard, riding a ring across the stage. Hib. Nice. Nice. Didn't get me too far, but it's still nice. I brought your kids back. Whoop. Hello. What's that? You found my grandkids? You gave the blobfish kid. Oh me, oh my, you found them. This makes me fit to burst with the rapturous joy. I'd like to give you something in return. Let me check my creepy handbag. You got the race tickets, 2 of 2. Hooray! That's a ticket for something or other. It came in the mailbox postage paid. So it's probably something your young folks are into. Off you go now. So hooray, we got something else. And I do believe that I might be able to do something else here. Let me go try. Let's at least give it a shot. I'm pretty curious as to if I can or not. So this should be pretty interesting. We're going to need to climb all the way back up to the top here, which is going to be difficult because the things are moving a little faster than they used to be. I'm not sure if that was, if you could tell that they were moving slightly faster. This gives me a chance to start collecting a little more gems, just to get them in my pocket. Yep. Yep. Rip. Oh boy. No! I didn't mean to fall, dang it. Oh, poop. Ugh, you bastard. Stop hurting me. Wow, he gave me a gator steak. Okay. Whatever you say, dude. Whatever you say. I'm not gonna worry about that. Ooh, but that's a big pot of gems, baby. Gimme. Girl, you know I want that money. Mm-mm. Okay, so I have to make this jump. And make this jump. No! No, I fell. I didn't want to fall. I'm good at bid games. I'm good. There we go. I did it. Just a little bit of complaining, and you get what you want. Don't learn from me, kids. Bad influence. Bad influence. I'm not very good. I'm only subpar at best. Because I kept you waiting, huh? And how far do I... Oh, son of a biscuit. Blah, blah. Alright, I should be in the area now. I might not even actually be able to get to it quite yet. I might just be blowing smoke right now, but I really want to give it a shot. Alright, so I can get to the door. Now the thing is, can I actually do the puzzle? Yep. Yep. I'm not sure if I require another transformation, but it looks like I may be in luck. So far, I'm making it through without any problems. Then use the bat here. I might be doing something a little early. I think they want you to use a different transformation here, but I think you can fandangle your way around by falling and doing the spider thing. So, yep. Ho, ho, ho! I think I cheated the system. And with that, boom! We get an item that we're not going to learn about till later. You got the data chip. Isn't that nice? But with that, we can finally leave this area. Oh boy, this episode's running on a little long, but I kind of need to get it out of the way. Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. So with that out of the way, we have one more place to go visit, and it's of course Main Street. With our new ability to turn into the elephant, the crab, and the mermaid, there's a couple of things we can do here. Nope, sorry, save guy. I'm ready. Okey-doke. I would skip ahead, but the stuff we need to do is actually relatively near this area. It's like as soon as you get into the water, because if you remember, there's a bunch of water areas here. Turn into the crab. I'm probably going to turn into the crab a bunch and just check the water. Some of the areas don't have anything in them, but I think most of them do. But here we have a heart container. You could have came back and got this if you wanted earlier. I didn't because I just honestly didn't need to. I'm going to turn into the mermaid because the mermaid has a unique thing where the starfish love her, so they won't attack her in the water, which is pretty cool. So, good. Also, this song is still pretty tits. Neo Burning Town. Recommend listening to it if you can't hear it. Because, you know, the way I edit my videos, I have to make sure that the volume is decent, but it might not be audible while I'm talking. Bleh. Ba-boink. And the next set of water should be just over yonder. But I do want these gems because I am a money whore. Transform. I think we need to be... Not the spider. I should have got the metronome. The metronome would make this a lot easier because it speeds up the process of dancing. Yes, here we go. I'm pretty sure I can do this. Yeah, it's just a chest. I don't know why this is inside of a doorway. Actually, this is kind of confusing. But we got a green stone. What that does is When you whip green gems, it converts them into magic, which I'm going to turn off because that's dumb. But hey, it's required for 100%, and now you know. Not the spider. I got to remember that all the swimming ones are down. You have to press down. Go, 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 Speed Racer, he's a demon. Do the starfish blow up when I get out of the water? Those poor, poor bastards. They don't know what's coming. They don't know what they've got till it's gone. All right, I think this is nothing here. No, this is. You need the mermaid to get to this because the crab can't reach that. Hello, sir. You look rather interesting. What's your name? Hey, girl. I'm the Adventure Man. You an adventurer like me? You like games? I got a game. Here goes. Okay. Guess what? Monkey butt. Nah, that was lame. Listen, since you made it all the way here, tell you what. I'm giving you this Vorpal Blade. I swiped it from the Azure Knight a while back. You got the Vorpal Blade. That blade is wicked Vorpal. I even dunked it in baby monkey tears to make it even more Vorpal. So Vorpal it hurts. Well, that's rather interesting and honestly sort of random. But hey, look at that. We completed another side quest without even trying. Isn't that neat? Isn't that fancy? I do believe we're just about done with this place and this episode, as a matter of fact. Once I get this last thing, we're going to end it because this has been going on for, from what I can tell, at least 30 minutes. I've been playing the game for 30 minutes at least, at the very least. I know I'm going to cut some stuff out a little bit, but it's not much. Bam. Ba-ba-bam. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-bing. The next thing we need, you probably remember seeing at the beginning of the LP, but there was a flower here. Hello, save guy. Goodbye, save guy. Turn to the monkey, because the monkey is the quickest to get around. Boop, boop, beep, boop, boink. Oh, poopy. There we go. Okay, so there is two things we can do here. Well, there's two things left to do here, and we're about to do one of them, so once we do this, there's only one more item that you can get from this area, and you can't get it until you get another transformation. Fancy that, right? Get out of here. Leave me alone, Tinkerbats. Boink, 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 boink. Yeah, my finger rolled off the thing. Okay, yep. Did I turn into the... Why would I turn into the elephant? The elephant is not gonna help me here. I'm gonna turn into the bat, actually. Whoop. Actually, do I want to? Oh, poop. It actually didn't matter that I was the bat. I think it's somewhere around here. Hearts? Nope. Okay. Right here. Here we go. And boom! Another piece of scrap metal added to our inventory. So with that, we have finished. We can go back because we have been going on quite a long time. Nothing but backtracking, but we should be prepared to continue on now because we now have the race tickets. And we can give those to Roddy to progress the story. So, hooray! We did it! Backtracking completed. Everybody give yourself a pat on the back. But that is all the time we have for this one. A hero's work is never done. Join me again next time as we continue to tackle Shantae, Half-Genie Hero. Later days, everybody.